Nathan's on point.
Graph is probably going to be used pretty soon.
Yeah, Nathan on point. He's fighting the Tracer duel. He's maybe losing the Tracer duel, not really sure. And meanwhile, in that time, he's backcapping, and I think he might make it. He doesn't make it, and Beglalis, it is just getting absorbed. Well, that was sad. Stick goes wide. And definitely, Vermelon finds Dino and follows during this. Primal Rage gets forced out, but. However, the Valk is keeping everyone alive. Flawless trains in Melon. Mazen finds Nuttier. Yak, though, does find Frosty, who's gonna put a chunk and dent in the healing. But Flawless gets another thing. 10 seconds. I don't think they're gonna be able to pull this.
They will be able to touch it. Nuttier is going to try to touch again.
Fire Carter just runs down Nate Melon in the.
Of a fire carter with two. Flawless with one.
And it's going to. Yak stuck. I think he makes it out. In fact, they punished Flawless for just Leroying in. Flawless is low. Frosty's low. And they do find Frosty. They get big.
Oh, how about the thing?
Nathan just eats it. Poor Nathan.
Yeah, the ult doesn't get anyone.
Nathan gets two. Nathan, do you see Firecracker gets the? Ida gets one. Nathan gets a third.
Yes, we're going point.
We're
actually going to see it. Truce is with the off angle, and he gets the only kill on EJ.
Yes, to see. Great job, Foos.
We're going to see the Blizzard is going to.
Blizzard just goes a bit wide. Yak is a double kill. And Message Resume, they did not see
him. Everyone's low. Nathan's still invested with the double.
Nuttier boots Nathan into Wiggle Higgle. Close supports are down.
They do get the fourth point. We're going to see a lot of ults be used this final fight. We're going to see a good.
We managed to get out of the Molten Core before everything bad, before it all happens.
Neptune does jump onto the backline, but likely will pay for it with his life. Grav also used just a solo ult to Lucio. Blizzard is used. Catches Mei. And somehow does not catch the Mei there. And the Alagato is just able to kind of stabilize off that aggression. And out, manages to escape. But meanwhile, Neptune just goes for the backline there. Somehow already has a copy. Copies the Winston.
What happened there is Lambo left the Ana and the Ash.
Oh.
Neptune saw that and just hardened.
Yeah. Great call by Neptune to identify and
just assume you take that. Probably use Bobby to engage.
Neptune showing his flexibility here. Copies the Ana and just the Sayori is able to get up here. Tommy Slap falls really low. Do we need to find Fancy there? Skyster finds Neptune on the other side. Paradox falls super low. Does eventually get taken down by Poke, but Skyster actually has two this fight. Looking for more. Gets the Lucio. Poke falls super low here. The recall is used to keep Poke nice and healthy here, but Nemoza.
You need that win.
Senior run from both sides. Skyster tries to kill onto Tommy Slap. Does still have this primal. Man, both supports are killed by Skyster. Fancy uses this High Noon, trying to force out the Echo. And Neptune does end up falling. Poke forced to recall there. Getting chased down 2v1 versus Skyser and Flabo Jambo. D-Mech onto Pneumonia, and I think they are going to stagger this D.Va here, too.
Yeah.
The mech. They just burn it again.
It's like a free.
Rampage might not use it here. Kitsune Rush Big rampage there. Beat is used, but a little bit too late. Nemoja still gets two. Oh, sorry, that was the beat from War. I think this is just all cleanup for Skycer here. The mech actually comes back out, but... Oh my god, 0.2%. Poke manages a touch. Neptune gets a kill. He's so close to this duplicate, too. Dude, that might be all they need. Fancy gets a kill into Poke, but Neptune just able to get so much value. Gets three. Looks for more. Skycer has to back here. Does get taken down by Pneumonia.
Oh my god. That
touch
by Poke.
By Poke.
And Rusty taking the space, but the E doesn't come into effect. Fedora's gonna trade with this barrage onto Harchar. The stabilizations, they're on point. They need to find a pick onto Zinth here. Rusty's trying to dive it, put Zinth with a nice little slide to get out of dodge. Fedora finds Noon and Trance, facing in towards that window on the high ground. Norton trying to abuse with the form from that position, not gonna be able to find anything. All they catch is Norton falling down, Rusty getting D-Max on the point. Fedora trying to make some heroics happen. But Elko is just there with the cleanup, with the picks, with everything they need.
And as you see, Fedora's playing really reserved, just trying to poke out Elko. And he's an amazing dive onto the backline, getting Sonic Ronic and getting into both backline.
Yeah, that was great. The explosion there from Richard Rath looking reminiscent to first point in Apollo.
Should turn in their favor. And Elko gets picked very early.
That was a perfect, a perfectly timed barrage. That's the exact question you want. And the bomb from Rusty finds three onto Asmodeus. The barrage comes out, catches Rusty, but gets traded out. Fedora finds one. Teddy M goes down as well. The red's gonna come out. Sonic Ryan, does he get it? No, he doesn't. Nort with the shutdown. Nort with the hero plane. Elko builds the ultimate. Drops down on the point.
Finds on the point.
They do jump forward here. Torp turret gets placed down. A lot of face taken in a big fire strike from Rusty Goomba. He finds two. They're going in. They're taking names. Window for the side of Guangdong. But it's not going to find anything. The ultra coming in second for Richard Rats. It's going to be almost everything.
Holy lord.
Finds three.
I'm wrong where hopefully Rusty can find a lot of picks. But Alco just gets a nice off angle onto Negro.
Yep, great. Space being made. But Fedora finds a nice pick in response. Pick's going on favor of Guangdong Magic Tigers. Red Taxi does manage to clean up Rusty. Guangdong, trying to get this engagement onto Sonic Chronic, does manage to find it, but now split out from the rest of the team in Red Taxi with some nice cleanup. But meanwhile, on the point, they ignored Nord. They ignored the main damage dealer for the Richfield Rats. And now, Red Taxi is forced to invest in Dilation, but it's actually Harchar, the one who's keeping up the team and providing the damage for that they're engaging on it, but it might be too much pull. It might be too much for them, but no, Rusty comes in with the big shatter. They even get out the window from Harchar. Fedora on the point, finds three. All right, and look at the speed, look at the aggression, look at the core. The core is just so good for the zoning ultimate, but a boop from Sonic is gonna be the hero play. And that's two ults for one of the Richfield Rats. They have the ult advantage, and not only that, they're getting staggers too. But it's even on both sides as supports from Guangdong Magic Tigers are managing to put in some serious work. I mean, Harchar is quite the aimer here, I won't lie, but...
Has to probably be here very shortly. But they make it a
really
play.
Good rotation.
Oh.
It is a winnable position. The B comes in a bit late. Only heals three members of the team up. Norton's the last one on the point. Trying to stabilize the rest of the team. Teddy M with a bit of heroics, though. Does manage to catch out Elko. Now looking at this Lucio 1v1 versus Sonic Chronic. But Zinth and Sonic are there on the point to get the cleanup. The flip does come in. But is it going to be to any avail? Rusty pins in onto the point. But it's the entire side for the Guangdong Magic Tigers.
Just comes out on point. Just like really helping Norton. Just staying here.
And Flip-Flop just landing so much space on that high ground. Denying the presence of 2/3 players. And the Pulse Bomb stick for Silent Guana Magic Tigers. They haven't really used anything just yet, but they haven't needed to, as Elko finds another pick onto Rusty Goomba. Asmodeus denying Flip-Flop on that space, and even finds themselves a second on the point in a favorable position. Zen trying to get the stabilization, and Invictus is going to be the one to find the kill. Corey now with a bit of cleanup too, so this is turning in the favor of Farmington Fisherman. Buffoonie's back on the Doomfist, so will this composition be able to stand the test of time? As Teddy M does get one, against Kathek. And the stability is really good.
Yeah, and they ultimately went out. You know, great job from the fishermen in realizing maybe they're not. Hold my words, hold my tongue. Let's see, let the finish us out here. And Mikey's the last one, 2v1, with PJ coming back. And now Huni's back as well, so this should just... But Loki's back too with Blossom. He might be able to use and win out.
I mean, if you're the Kiwis, you're happy with all the stall you got on this point. Yoda and Loki. So now Booney looking for the shadow, but gets absolutely melted by the window. And now time becomes a concern as Purple Jesus pressing the aggression, pressing forward towards the point. Teddy M with some good cleanup on the high ground, helping out the team, supporting the team here, but no ultimates to come in. Loki with the tire from spawn, looking to get some value and finds two on the point. Booney used the shadow, nothing found from it. And it's just cleanup for the Kathmandu Kiwis.
The fishermen respond with their own ults. And Tori did get his nano Ajax too.
Oh, and the DPS ults to follow up here too. From the Kiwis, it's just so powerful, so oppressive. Desperate Straits goes in with it, trying to find something, but it's completely stifled. A shadow comes in from Booney though, taking the opportunity, taking the space made by Yoda to clean up the point. And Kathek has the Glock out. It's gonna be able to clean up one. It makes it very tough for the side of the Permanent Fisherman to answer back, but a great deflect. Yoda finds two.
Now it's gonna become a Shatter War here.
Yes, whoever hits the Shatter. One Shatter's big, and PJ blocks the second. That's gonna be massive for the Kathmandu Kiwis. Also traded out and nothing left. It's just, they're still able to find Centurion. And now Kathek trying to go into the back line to get a big hero play. Not able to find it. The High Noon comes out. It's gonna be able to click one, but Yoda's trying to turn this. Yoda with three on the point. Invictus cleans up one as well. An ult to pull here. And it's actually gonna be Senton who goes first with the Death Blossom to find two. The cleanup is there. The High Noon gets popped. Just
Rampage to play for is just gonna be so important.
Yeah, and Yoda definitely posturing for it. Has a really good angle to take it, but instead they're gonna kite back and Teddy M finds three.
And Senton going to point and looking for it. Solo Blossom Charm, but he ends up finding her.
And he's gonna be able to get the cleanup two onto Ninja Drew. That's gonna be massive. Sent finds three. He wants to chase down Loki too.
You know, Peter is gonna come through on the Rekutessen. This should probably just win out for their team.
No, but Loki gets exploded, so it's actually gonna be a trade on either side. Kathek's putting in work on the point here. Cleans up two. And now it's an advantage for the Farmington Fisherman. Yoda doing it, comes in, but it's gonna get shielded off, needs to get blocked out. Is he gonna find something? No, Teddy M gets the shutdown at the last second. Mikey's here for the hero plays, for the heroics, for the stabilization on the point. Blow it up, tries to peek from multiple angles, but isn't gonna be able to find it. Some great healing comes in, and another big purple comes out from Corey as well. So supports are gonna be traded out. Sent looking for that extra damage, looking to dive up on that high ground. Doesn't find anything just yet. Invictus is there for the cleanup though. Corey attempts to leap. Doesn't find it just yet though. As Loki gets the stabilization on the point, kills out Centurion, looking for the second one, and Purple Jesus back for the recontest, helping to stabilize Loki on this point. But Yoda's back on the D.Va from Loki to support the team. And Nano is gonna come in. But Yoda finds the bomb! That's gonna shut down three. That might be exactly what they need. As the Nano dissipates, Yoda gets the fourth as well. And some nice cleanup here. They need to find a shutdown onto Mike, and they need to find it quick. He is building that pulse bomb over onto this Junker Queen. And he's actually gonna manage to hunt down Ninja Drew. No block to save him, so it's an opportunity. It's at least an opening, a chance for Centurion to go in. And he's gonna manage to find Loki, looking for Teddy M2, catch them as well. This fight has turned winnable here in the fight. And Mikey's left uncontested on this high ground position. Invictus does find another one too, and Corey with the rush coming in, sent so close to this blizzard, that could turn the fight, that could turn the pace of everything. He is gonna pull it down straight onto Purple Jesus. And Mikey finds two with the barrage. Is that gonna be enough though? Invictus being the hero on point, the Deadeye closes. Loki, exactly what they're doing, Helpful Centurion on the point. Mikey looks for the pulse bomb. He's gonna
find it.
Fiona backs up the wrong way. It shuts down three. Mikey comes up with a big hero play to clean up the point. Zoo go for the explosion out onto the high ground. But it's gonna be Yoda with the cage fight. And so much damage is coming in off the back of that as well. Mikey's looking to turn this, but he can't do anything in this situation. His teammates are just exploding all around him. Stabilization is just so good. Loki tries to invest the best blossom, but isn't gonna find.